that's what I'm saying. Like, the Muslim is not, because obviously we live in a, you know, like, not in a Muslim. Yeah, that's not. No, exactly. So that's the difference. But whereas, like, obviously, if we got married here or in Utah, we would get married to a Catholic church. And so because it's a Catholic church, even though it's a church, it's a Catholic church. And it's plus fine. Whereas if yeah, when you have like, or if you have a Sikh wedding or a...
Parks, hope you enjoy them. Now this is a history tour, but a historic pub tour more so than a history tour per se, because obviously it's based around the pubs. But it's not just history of pubs, it's also history of where we are, some contextual stuff, a few spots in the field as well. Everybody cool with that? Everybody okay with that, yeah? Reason I say is I'm trying to balance. I had 14 Liechtenstein on a tour, not too long ago. A private tour, it was a stag do, something called Bachelor's Party. Pretty much half the population living in the state. And predictably, they couldn't care less about the history of the tour together. Completely smashed. See, like, what's the point of looking up the story and talking about the history of the tour? So, balance is key. Hopefully, we'll find something to eat. God, drunk, really up front, meals for the first 3 months, each pub for the first three for about 25-30 minutes. And then the last one, obviously, as long as you want, because that's where the tour ends, but obviously not to much for a huge meal. Rapas is absolutely fine, which is British tapas, so small plates, that's fine, small stuff, nothing more than that. Beer is the name of the game over here for the most part, but anybody here not a beer drinker? It's always one. Fine. What's your beverage? You're in luck. It's the very first pub we're going into. It's the last remaining genuine authentic old Victorian gin palace in London. So there's other gin palace style pubs in Buckingham Palace, but this is the last authentic real one. So you'll be in luck there, and anyone else loves gin in Buckingham Palace. Excellent stuff. The rest of you are all happy with beer, generally. Are you familiar with the pubs? You are. Are you past ale? Yeah, are you a big past drinker yourself?
Yep.
Are the rest of you familiar with the past ale, also known as real ale? Some of us, yeah. But you don't know what it is. Yeah, so basically, it is a centuries old traditional type of beer around this country. That was done for many, many years in kind of more wooden cast barrels, as opposed to stainless steel keg barrels, undergoes a technical fermentation. I won't bore you with the science. Basically, the serving is stored at a warmer temperature than what you're used to these days, and now adding carbon dioxide, no carbon dioxide added. Right, so that's where this conception comes from. Old English beer is in flat, which is in Australia.
You just have to share the statue here, guys.
So it's really much holy. It's not really my friend, but I also recommend it to people for outside.
Guys,
hope you're all excited today. Are you all feeling it?
Woo!
Yes, yeah, that's the energy. Right, there. Let's get on this level, guys, okay? Cool. A bit of housekeeping first and foremost, just so we're all on the same page. It's going to be about 3.5 hours today. But distance from first pub to last pub is about a mile. Today we'll be visiting four pubs. This is the last temporary run pub in the city of London. We're going to be visiting a lovely gin palace named after the oldest pub in the city of London. We're going to be finishing off at a lovely 300-year-old castle pub that used to be in the tea house. Should be fun. Has anyone got any mobility issues that you know about? Like filming through stairs, anything like that? All the pubs have toilets in them. If you ever need them, just ask me. I know where they all are. We should be able to get them. Cool. Right. Now I'll just get all that fun stuff out of the way. Let's get started. We'll get started right here at St. Paul's Cathedral, probably one of the most famous buildings in London, in North Europe. This is the fourth version of St. Paul's Cathedral.
Probably because of the religious connotation, the shadow people can make them some space. Probably didn't want to offend the Church of England, but if you look very closely, she did manage to sneak in a pair of slightly oversized testicles. Now, believed by most, including myself, that if you give a man a squeeze or at least a light tickle, it's good luck. I'm not going to force you guys to do anything you don't want to do, it's not that kind of tour, but I've been doing it for a while, guys. Look at me, I'm raving. I recommend it, but hey, it's up to you. Feel free to go for a good luck squeeze or don't, and follow me this way. Straight into it. All right, there you go, with photographic evidence. Yeah. All right. Excellent. You feel like a different person already. You need all the look. There's an aura about you there.
So, the ball's obviously this ball has been very important to people in London. It's our spiritual part as London. So important.
I don't like being a cop. it was made.
Never saw you wear it before, so yeah.
Thank you.